start with these four. I have recently I have given you example about the check numbers, that we are entering check numbers proceeding with zero. So suppose I have entered some check numbers here. Let's see, there are some check numbers I have entered.
Mm-hmm.
Let's suppose accidentally I do it, I go to this array and convert to number. Now it is converted into numbers, but I need earlier one check numbers. How to do that? Do you know about it?
You mean like control Z maybe?
Let's suppose you have saved that and control Z option is not working, then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I will go to Excel options. Then.
Okay.
Then.
Come on, there is no option for that.
Yeah, there is no option. I'm trying to find something.
Okay.
What about if I press Alt?
So I have a solution for that. Just select the value, go to number formatting. Okay. And select custom. And here you will enter, suppose that I have I have 6-digit check number. So what I will do here, I will type 6 times 0 here. Okay.
Where and you type?
6 times 0. I just type here.
Okay.
Okay.
Then
if enter. It's okay, you will see it will return here.
Okay.
Now how this happened? What is the secret behind that? First thing you should understand, I am just working with number format on the visibility of data, not the reality. Suppose that kind of value which was you chose earlier, if I apply a sum formula, I do not get any value. But the same thing if I do with my this system, I convert to number this, then apply number form a custom formatting 6 times 0, then press OK. And if I apply some formula here, you can find the total of these numbers. So basically, I want to tell you that these are options was in text. Okay. Zero was actually existing there. But in that case, zero is not present here. That's why it's working with formula also. Okay. How you might have seen the currency sign. So currency is also a character, but it works as a number formatting, that's why we can total currency values also. Okay. It is the same thing I have done with that. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now let us understand how to use this custom formatting. How do we recognize where it will be needed to us? Let's press F1 from our keyboard, and in Excel help you type custom format. Okay. There are no option available, no help available here itself. So there are help modes available here in this search button. First is content from Office Online, and this one is these helps from content from this computer. So you need to take online help for that. So I just go to online Excel help, then I'll find create a delete or delete a custom number format. Okay, I just click on that.
Okay.
And there are the options for custom formatting. Okay, let me explain that. I have used zero. This digit placeholder display insignificant zero. If a number has fewer digits than zero, then there are zero in the format. Okay. Suppose if you type 8.9 and you want to display it as 8.90, use format #.00. Okay. After decimal, we have applied two zeros for displaying value like this. In short, you can understand if I have given 6 times 0, if any digit will not be there, it will be filled with 0. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Let's suppose I type here some values. 12.1. 0.1, 8.296, 9.3. Then I apply a format custom format 0.00. So if after decimal, if there is no value, it will show me 0 there. Okay.
0.
In this option, zero, zero. You can see there were 0.
Mm-hmm.
There were not 0. There are values in 3 digits. But I have given here in custom format only 2 digits. That's why it is showing me the value in 2 digits.
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So this option you can use with numbers only. You can't use this option with text or date. Okay.
Yeah.
Now one more thing I have available. Suppose that I usually send you a mail regarding meeting ID. You can see there is meeting ID of 9 digit. I want to enter only 9 digit, but I want to fix that hyphen with after 3 digits. Okay.
Okay.
So how what I will do here? I just go to custom format. This the hash is the brother of zero, but it never forces a digit to paste as zero. If there will be less digit, it will be acceptable with this. Okay, it does not force to fill with zero, but the working is same. What type of working I want? I want to put hyphen sign after 3 digit. See, the hash and zero, are the placeholders of digit. Okay. In general, we are just telling computer that in what format it should display us. Okay. So I have applied. Yeah. Now I just give the value. So it will separately distribute the value. Okay.
Let's how we add, excuse me, how we added the dash?
I'm just telling you. I just wrote this hyphen sign there, dash. Okay. Suppose that I am giving value more than the digit value I have given there. Okay. So what it will do? See, what format I have applied there? ###########. This value I have applied there. So you can see there are 9 values. So first 3 digit will be captured by the first 3 digit. The last 3 digit will be captured by the last one. Then it will put and dash there. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then
more
3 digits and then another dash, you can see here. Then more 3 digits. There are nothing in front of this hash. So that's why it is putting all the values there. It is displaying 4 digits in this option. Okay.
Yeah.
Where we can use it. Suppose that I think what is the US telephone code 001, I think.
Okay.
Or what? Suppose that in India system, we
it's 001.
Yes. So suppose that there is a phone number. I want to type phone number here, but I want that my country code should add automatically here. So, what I will do, I will type 001, then I need dash, then I need means digit placeholder. If I put a single digit, then also it will appear here. Now I type any phone number. Okay, it's not working like that, so I just try again. I just give this values in inverted commas. Then I think it will work. Okay, so it is working now. Now see what I have done here. If I don't put this hash, then what happens? I put any of the value, it will display me this one only. The code which I have applied here. But hash, see in the sample box, when I press hash, the rest of the value, means the digit placeholder, gets the rest of the value. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
This is the thing. Suppose that I want to display this one only, 245 with country code. What was the option with that? I just need to provide inverted commas. But you can see dash is working without inverted commas. But for 001, I am providing inverted commas. I am keeping these values in inverted commas. Why? Because you can see in this list these signs, dollar sign, plus sign, this left parenthesis, colon, caret, and minus sign, hyphen sign means you can use these things without any inverted commas. These codes are acceptable without inverted commas. Rest of all you can apply with under inverted commas. Okay.
Okay.
You can see I can do this thing very easily. So now you can understand how this hash and zero is working.
I think so. Yes.
Ah.
I just go to custom, then I'll type, let me see, I'll go to custom first, then
I will
in the place of general, I'll type,
I will give you
hashtag
001, inverted comma close, hyphen, and then a single hash. It gets the value, but if I want to define the value more, that after one digit I need hyphen, so I will apply more hashes here like this. Okay.
Okay.
Let's try this code in this option only. So this is the thing.
Mm-hmm.
What was the code? This one. Okay, when you put a single digit, it will get all the value, but when you bifurcate this, that first digit should be here and after that this character should be there, so you can give more definition of each one digit. Okay.
All right. Yeah.
Now we know how to work with zero and hash. Now let's take more example of that. In this list every option is given here. So let's suppose we have value 1234.59 and we want to display as 1234.6. So what code we will give? Hash hash hash, four time hash dot single time hash. Okay. Then for 8.9 I want to display as 8.900, means in 3 digit. So what I will do? Hash, here I need to force the value to be in 3 digit. So when forcing is concerned, then you need to put 0.
Okay.
Let's suppose you have entered only 0.631. You have not entered 0.631. You have entered only 0.631. Now you want to force the value that it should display 0.6, whether there is 0 given or not. So what code you will apply? 0.hash. Displaying the value for single time. You can use 0 also here.
Mm-hmm.
In place of
what's the difference? What is the difference between 0 and hash? I mean,
0 forces to fill the places. This was different.
Okay. And the hashtag?
Let's suppose here, let's see this example. Here it will be clarified to you. In one place I have typed 12.
Okay.
And I want to display as 12.0. Then what I am applying? When forcing is concerned, then hash dot 0. And again hash. But what is special in this format? I want to display if the value are decimal places are more than 2, then I want to display the value in 2 places. Okay. And if there is nothing, I want to display the value after decimal in 1 place. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see here it is 0.568, 1234.568. So it is showing me 1234.57 in two digits. Okay, these are digit placeholder, but zero force, if there is no value, it force that it should be zero. Okay.
Yeah.
This is the main difference only. In this example, you can understand all working of hash and zero. Okay.
All right.
Then another placeholder we have for digit placeholder. This is question mark sign. But what it does? I just copy these values here. Let me just copy. And one more value, 2.8. Okay, I apply here same format. Now I want to align my decimal points. Suppose that the decimal should be in middle, and I want to for and that can be possible only if I apply a code 3 times question mark dot then 3 times question mark. I want to keep my format like 3 values should be before decimal and 3 values after decimal. So I want to make a format like this for 3 values before decimal, 3 values after decimal. If there is no value, it should save the space for that, maintain the space for that. So when I apply this formatting, I just copy the same value here, but apply this code there in custom formatting. 3 times question mark dot 3 times question mark. Okay, so you can see the dots are in between. There is 2 decimal values up to 2 decimal places only, but it is maintaining the space of third one also. Here the decimal places are for single value only, but it is maintaining for 3 here. That's why our decimal aligned here. Okay?
Yeah, got it.
So this is just for alignment. Maybe you don't require it, but let's take it for knowledge sake. Then for aligned fractional values, here we have aligned decimal, and if we want to align this slash sign, so we can use this code. Okay, you can try it on. Then let's move further. Suppose that I want to display 12,000 as with a comma separator. Okay, I need a comma here. So what code I will use? I will use hash comma 3 times hash. Okay. Comma always captured as a 1000 position. Okay.
So yes,
if I want to display 12,000 as 12 only, I'm not using paste special here, just for the sake of formatting. I want to do it as by formatting itself. So if I'm not giving any digit after this comma, so it will leave these 3 zeros. That's why it is displaying 12 only. Okay.
Yeah, that's clear.
So comma is particularly the separator for thousand only. When you insert comma in that, the computer understand it is meant for thousand only. As the second comma you use for million. If you give two commas, it will take as million.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You can see the value here. These are thousand and India we have lakhs. So it is leaving the position. And you can see there, if I apply this much of value here, and when I apply a comma separator from here, or I can choose in number formatting comma separator, so it is showing me comma here. Okay, the first comma was for thousand and second comma was for million. So it is displaying me after these values, after leaving these values, it is picking up the decimal places of these values. 0.0 means 12.2, means you can see 12 and this comma 0.2. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's difficult to understand, but when you use this kind of things, you will understand automatically. Okay. That this comma separator is for thousand, million and billion. What is program, what the programming is available in computer as per that. But in Saudi Arabia, you count in million or you count in lakhs. In India, we count in lakhs. You don't count in million.
We count million, million and billion and this.
Okay, you count you count in million and billion. So that is available, but sometimes you know, if I want to our currency is like that, we usually apply we have this this much is 1000 for us, 12,000, and when I fix any one, so this is we apply like this, we apply commas like this, 1,12,000, we don't have so comma is different in our Indian currency. So we use customized format with that. But when we apply this comma, so comma usually computer understand for million and billion. But to program like that, we have to reverse the effect of comma. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just telling you the example that how I do it. So this is my value where I want to apply this thing. I just go to custom and apply here hash dot 00.
Yeah, just a question. Now for the first hash is,
but it is not working here. You can see it is not working here.
Yeah.
In what format I have given it, it is not working here. So I need to reverse the effect of comma. I just apply it again, but it is not working. I need to reverse the effect of comma with slash. Then I press comma. Because when I insert any comma, it understand as a billion. So to reverse the effect, I used an slash. Okay. And then I press OK, I will find my value in this format.
Yeah, I get it now.
Got it. So we can use that. Now we can apply colors to these values. Okay. The colors available are here. The colors except these are not working in these formats. Where we apply, where we usually apply color, if you have seen in number, there is color option. So these colors can be done with that. If you want to see the code of that, let's suppose I am applying any value in negative. Oh, there it is. If you want to know the code of it, it is in negative, and then applying this formatting. Okay. Now I want to know the what is the code for it. I just go to custom, and I will find the code applied here.
Okay.
In date, time, whatever the code, you can apply from these formats, and you will find. Showing in Chinese, I just changed the language of, so you can find here which one I have applied. Okay.
Yes.
So we can apply color also, any color. Suppose that I want to display the value as display the value as I need to use these big brackets, big parentheses. So I will type yellow. So it will be converted in yellow. But you can see, you can't see it. Yellow. Okay. So we can apply some colors here in this list. Let's suppose that we want to apply some condition to its formatting. Let's suppose an option is available here. Let's take it here, then and we will understand. This is a logical condition here that the value which is greater than which is less than equal to 100 will be displayed as red. This is a logical condition. And we apply semicolon here. Then next condition, the value which is greater than 100, it should be displayed as blue. Our condition also comes in big brackets. Okay. I apply with a list. There I type 90, 50. So there are four values, and apply the same formatting in that, in custom. So you can see the value which are less than 100, it is in blue. Okay. The value is greater than 100, and the value is which is greater than 100, it is in blue. The less than equal to 100 is in red. Not for colors, we can give these conditions to every format, but for format we have to define a logical condition like this. Suppose that for the value greater than less than 100, I want to show in double decimal format. Okay?
Okay.
Now the value which is greater than 100, I want to display the value as in triple decimal value. Okay. I apply this code. So you can see the difference.
Yeah.
The values are in double format, here are in triple decimal. Okay. So we can apply these formats on the basis of condition also. Actually, this topic was hidden for a very long time. People don't know about these options because there are few codes only. What we can do with codes, we don't understand that. But when we have explored this, so and these tools were very powerful. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, let's see with dates. How we can play with our dates. I have applied here date. Now I change the formatting in custom. So what is the default format for that? m/d/yyy.
Okay.
Okay. So for if I type D only, so it will show me
on day.
Day. Day. The date is 26th September, but it is showing 26 only. Let's suppose if there is a day 3 September, so it will display 3 only. Okay. Now I want this in double digits. So I will apply D, D 2 times D. So it will show me in double digits. When I apply 26 here, so it will come in double digit. Okay. For displaying dates in double digit, we use 2 times D. But here see the magic. If I apply 3 times D, then it will display value in abbreviated day name. It's Friday. Okay. So it is showing me abbreviated name FRI only. Okay. Now I apply 4 times D. So it is showing me full day name. Okay.
Okay.
So you can apply up to 4 times D. For single time D, you will get the value of day. 2 times D, you will get the value in 2 digits. 3 times D, you will get the abbreviated day name. 4 times D, you will get the full name of the day. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now same as you have with months. If you apply M, it will show you the month. When you apply 2 times M, it will show you the month in double digit. When you apply 3 times M, it will display abbreviated month name. When you type 4 times M, it will display full month name. And you can apply 5 times M also. In that case, it will show you the initial of the month only. Okay?
Alright. Yeah.
The same with years. But here in years, there are 2 formats only. Either you can show your years in double digit. For that you can use YY only, YY, so in, year in 2 digits, and second format is 4 times Y, so year in 4 digits.
Mm-hmm.
You can't apply 3 digits there, 2 digits and yes. 4 digits for year.
That's right.
Now I want to display customized date. I can use them all in single code also. Suppose that I want to display abbreviated day name first, then comma, space, then I need two digit day name, two times D, then I need hash there, then I need abbreviated month name, three times M, then I apply dash here, then I need four digit here, Y. Okay, when I press OK to that, so here is the format. If I want to display many times full day name also, so I can apply it there also. No matter how many times you repeat that.
Okay.
So this is all with dates. And if you want a list, so list is available here. How it works, how to display months. If you want to show months like this, use this code, use this code, use this code. You have whole list here.
Yeah.
For time, you have whole list.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Let's see the example of time. I type time here. Because there are a lot of formats for time also. So what format we use? When I type H, it will show me hours only. In 24 hours format. If you want if I type 2 times H, it will display hours in 2 digit. Let's suppose you want in 12 hour format. So there is a 3 formats you can use. AM/PM. Okay, this is first format. When you OK this, so it will get you 2 digits hour value and AM, PM, whatever will be applicable. You can use A/P, so it will display you the initial, and you can use in capital also, if you want in capital. Okay. So you can get in capital also. Okay, this is for 12 hour format, and if you remove this AM PM, it will be in 24 hour format. Okay, now I press colon. I don't press colon. I need minute. It will not display the minutes only. Minutes. Let's see.
MIN?
No, use. It actually doesn't work separately because it get confused with your date system.
Yeah.
Okay, because there is M for month only. Month also. So it will display you January if you type double type M. So it is displaying you the value for January. That is the problem here. So we can tackle this with reading H sign. And then we use MM, so it will display you the correct value. Okay. Or you can display M colon SS, then only it will give you the only value, SS for seconds. Okay.
Yeah.
It needed, I think, colon. Any other value for that. because it will get confused in either it should display month or minute. Okay. Now for HMS, two times H, these are the codes. But we were talking about time elapsed. So time elapsed, suppose that we have a date like, I just removed this AM PM. There are 36 hours. How to display that? So we will use, for hours we will use this big brackets, then I will provide H and then here you need only single time H. Okay, so it will show you 36. Suppose that you want to display minutes and seconds with column. So it will show you like this. Then you want to display the total elapsed minute only. So you can put minutes in big brackets. Okay. Then it will display only minutes. Now you want to display seconds only, elapsed seconds. So you will type big brackets, yes, and then SS, the total elapsed second. Okay. So there are the code you can use. Okay. Then we have more options. This is called time only. We have options for our text also. Whatever we have done till yet are with numbers, date and time. Now how to deal with text? There are few options but it is not available there, but I will tell you how to use that. Let's suppose I want to type here any company name and I want it should be in format Messrs. I want to apply this Messrs. Omex Limited. The company name is Omex Limited. I want to apply Messrs automatically. So what would be the code? M/S in inverted commas, because there is a space also, so I need a space in this inverted comma. Then what I will use? @. @ is a separator for text. So this code I will apply there. I just apply in this box in custom. I apply this code. Now when I type any value, Omex Limited, so I will find it is automatically fixing Messrs there. Then India. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
HCL. Okay. This thing you can do with your text. One more thing you can do, you type sometimes a format. Let's suppose you type name and for entering name, a print table format you want to, so you will apply this underscore many times. Okay. Now when you exceed this column and decrease this column, it will get lost the value there. Basically what I want to just repeat this underscore till the length of column width. So what I will do, I will type a code @. This is a placeholder for text in the cell. Then what I do, underscore star underscore. Star is for repetition. When I put star, that means after star, it, whatever we write, it will repeat till the column. Mm-hmm. Now you can see it is exceeding automatically. Whatever you apply there.
Okay, got it.
Okay. This thing you can do. And in my office, a guy was there. What he was doing, he was entering the in time and out time of employees. So he type like this. He type values always 10 colon 20, then 9 colon 30. So always he need to put these colons there. For pasting colons,
okay.
If we have lots of data to enter, so it will waste our lot of time in applying columns only. Okay. So I have created a format for that, for him, that you use 2 times 0, then space, colon, in inverted commas, then 2 times, 2 digits will be there. So this format I have designed for him, and let's suppose I apply here. Means 2 digits will be in left side and 2 digits in right side, in between I have placed column. So what I will type, if I have to type 1020, so 1020. Okay. If I have to type 930, 930. So I have made him very fast in data with this small code.
Yeah, this is good.
Okay.
Because I have to have problem with this, you know. I used to have problem with the entering time, you know, in this format. But I think with this, this one I can recover it.
Page and practice the value given only. Okay. Do not use a lot of many code. Gradually, when you learn Excel, you will know how to use it. Okay.
So, how to get this sheet or this help, Excel help? Is it
just
through the
just press F1 from your keyboard and go to insert. There is a button. Go to online help. This section is online help, this section is offline. So go in online help, and here you find, you type custom format. Okay, just search that. The first option you will get, create or delete a custom number format. Okay, so these are options you will get in there.
Okay. Yeah, get it.
Just practice that, and if you are not finding with your help, you can just take help of Google also. Just type custom format Excel. Okay, the first option, create a custom number format, create or delete a custom number format, second option.
Okay,
you'll find the same, I think.
Yeah.
Okay, but where it is, just press the plus. Okay, display both text and numbers. So in a different manner it is, and yes, there is a help for add the rate also. If you want to add spaces, repeat characters, you need to put asterisk. Here it is written everything. The options are same. How to use thousand separators, specify colors, specify conditions, include currency. Do not use it because it is absolute. Okay, so every option is available here. You can find it on internet also. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's all for today. So we will meet on Monday. Okay, sir.
Yes. Thank you. And I'll see you.
Should you need this?
Take care. Have a nice weekend.
Also, or you can practice that.
Yeah, I'll try my best.